Hey there, mama friend, and welcome to the 5-Minute Mom Podcast, where we'll talk about real life, real faith, real fast. For today's show notes or to get free Monday mom devotionals, visit audrahaney.com. Well, welcome back to the podcast, friends. I feel like when I mention the next spiritual discipline, we need to insert a dun-dun-dun. Because today we're going to talk about fasting. Am I the only one, or doesn't it strike so much fear and dread? We anticipate our misery and how horrible we'll feel when we're fasting, and we don't hear many sermons on it, and it's not something we see a lot of people practice. But the truth is, we saw Jesus and his disciples practice this consistently in the Bible. This is a powerful spiritual discipline, and it has so many spiritual benefits. Perhaps if we can understand it a bit more, maybe we can plan and execute effective fasting with more joy. I didn't know much or even try fasting until I was in my late 20s. However, after being obedient to start fasting, I look back on those times set apart and I remember them so vividly. I heard God so clearly. I saw Him move so definitely. I was focused on Him so fully. And I think sometimes we dread the discomfort but forget the thrill and the joy of being closer to God. And while I'm never eager to start fasting, I have never regretted it. Here are 3 quick reminders for busy moms. And for the purpose of this monologue, I'm only going to refer to fasting from food, although there are other ways to go about it. 1, the purpose of fasting is to turn our attention to Jesus and His kingdom. The purpose of fasting is to remove the distraction of food. Listen, it takes a lot of time to prep food. It takes a lot of time to think about what, when, how we will prepare our food. We don't like the feeling of hunger pains, but the truth is, most of us are far from starving to death. The hunger pains should be a reminder to turn our mind from earthly things to heavenly things and humble ourselves before God and let Him nourish our spirit. 2, whether you do a partial fast, a full fast, corporate or private fast, whether you're fasting for a specific thing or you're trying to implement it into your routine, your fast should have a very clear biblical purpose. Without a biblical purpose, you're simply dieting. Your purpose will help you feel like the sacrifice is worth it. Your purpose will keep your eyes on Jesus. The hunger to see God move in that area will trump the hunger that hits at dinner time. Pick a purpose that drives you to your knees and is so worth it. And 3, fasting can bring us closer to Christ, but we don't do it to appear more righteous. That's what the Pharisees did. This is an intimate and beautiful thing, and when we fast, we open wide the door for God to move. Don't trade it for the applause of men. And here's 3 quick ways busy moms can implement it into their everyday routine. 1, being a mom takes a lot of energy, and I know it can be a scary thing to think of fasting and feeling awful while you're trying to take care of kids. But can I remind you that fasting can be even one meal? Maybe even try a Daniel fast of fruits and vegetables or juice. Also, not only are there many spiritual benefits, but research has shown that regular fasting has tremendous benefit to our body as well, and you may actually feel better. 2, try fasting with some accountability. I think fasting with your spouse is usually the most effective, not only for unity and prayer, but also the logistics of food prep for the week. If not your spouse, try confiding in a trusted friend and have them pray with you and check in with you. And 3, let the Holy Spirit guide you as to when and how you should fast. He knows the demands on you as a busy mom, but He also wants to draw you to experience the miracles of fasting. When He does guide you to fast, trust Him that He will provide the strength and the energy as needed. That being said, if you are pregnant or breastfeeding, this is not the time to fast from food, but perhaps try something else that steals much of your time and attention. And here's some resources to help you grow in the spiritual discipline of fasting. First, the book Hunger for God by John Piper. Secondly, Dr. Josh Axe has some great articles on the health benefits of fasting. And finally, the Bible. Do a word study on fasting for some rich study. It will get you so excited about how God moves when His people fast properly. And to close, I'll leave you with this scripture from Isaiah 58, 6 through 9. Is this not the kind of fasting I have chosen, to loose the chains of injustice and to untie the cords of the yoke, to set the oppressed free and to break every yoke? Is it not to share your food with the hungry and to provide the poor wanderer with shelter? When you see the naked, to clothe them and not to turn them away from your own flesh and blood? Then your light will break forth like the dawn, and your healing will appear quickly. Then your righteousness will go before you, and the glory of the Lord will be your rear guard. Then you will call, and the Lord will answer. You will cry for help, and He will say, "Here I am." So that's the end of our 5 minutes. Please tune in again soon. If you want to learn more about me or sign up for the podcast newsletter or get a free devotional, visit audrahaney.com. And if you enjoyed this, would you please leave a quick review? Reviews are so important for podcasters, and it helps more moms find us, and it would be a great blessing.